pray that you open their minds, open their ears, Lord, open their hearts. May they not be ashamed to proclaim your name, Lord Father God, in front of each other and on their own, Lord Father God. I pray that you be here with me as I try to share this encouragement tonight, Lord Father God. And I just thank you. How beautiful it is when two or more are gathered in your name, Lord Father God. We just thank you that we're able to fellowship over these next few days. Thank you for the day that's been. Thank you for the day that is. Thank you for the day that will come, Lord Father God. In the holy precious name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
So I've shared a few times in front of people, in front of crowds, and it's never something that I can get used to. Shy person at times, and sometimes, well, I'm saying this as a disclaimer, because if I muck up, then please forgive me, but I'll try my best. So a few days ago, Mike asked me if I wanted to share a testimony tonight. I said yes, and part of it was because also Jerry shared last year's TYC for those of you who attended, and another because I've been talked to grasp a lot of people in the program by so many people, but ever since I was asked, I went about my days trying to figure out what I want to share. But it wasn't until I came to TYC that I realized there was an idea that was kind of coming through that I think God wanted me to talk about, which was just a reoccurring theme over these past couple of days. It's the idea of trial and error, or triumph after trial. For example, Mike talked about how he was trying to set up his prayer walk, but things kept not going his way. Also today spoke about when he was younger and he was trying to push for us as young people to be where we are today. There was times where he would speak in front of the elders of the church, but he would get shut down. Trying to do something for us. Also, Seal spoke this morning about something about God keeping things from you because they were never meant to be for you. I'm usually quite a carefree person. There's not much that usually gets to me, but these past few weeks have been real hard for me in my personal life. My patience, my perseverance, and my faith have been tested. And shout out to Team Faith. I can bet that there's a bunch of you here tonight who came to TYC in hopes of renewing their spiritual work, or at least finding salvation. Part of me did the same thing. But whatever it is that you're struggling with, I just want to say that God sees it. He sees it in your heart. And He wants to tell you that this darkness that you're facing is only temporary. And when you come out of this darkness, you'll be a better person because of it. The story that you have to share is the answer that maybe someone else is trying to look for. Amen?
Amen.
Romans 8, verse 18. For I consider that our present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed in us. Let me say that again. For I consider that our present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed in us. So Seal spoke also about young people who would live in a world where they thought they were alone. It also hurts me to think that that young people feel this way. Like I mentioned earlier, I went through my own trials. Dad got really sick. He got really sick, and doctors were talking about the possibility of lung cancer. Great supporting is vital to getting through tough times. But above that, know who you are in Christ. Know who you are in Christ and your faith in God. Shout out to Team Faith. Your faith in God is the most important. I'm qualified for it. And I can say this because I want you to have a support system. Feel free to hit me up if you feel like you need to talk to someone about anything. I'm usually free. I'm not really someone who I'm free. if you've forgotten everything I've said up until this point, I suggest you catch me outside. if you have forgotten, at least try and remember the story that I want to share with you. It's not my own story, but it's a story that's gotten me through so many hard times in my life. It's a story that I'll continue to share until I can no longer speak. Story goes something like this. Once upon a time, it's a true story. Once upon a time, many, many years ago, there lived this man called Horatio Spafford. And he was a dedicated Christian. He was a really hard worker as well. He was a lawyer. He was really hard worker. After years and years and years of hard work, finally decided that his family, or him, his wife, and three kids deserved a holiday week. So they planned to travel over to Europe where they'd meet a friend and spend summer break maybe over there. So they planned, and then right up until the day they were set to leave, things were good, and then Horatio's law firm called him up and said, we need your help. We've gone through an economic downturn and we need you to help us out. So he said, all right. He told his wife and kids to go ahead of him and he would stay home, or he would stay back and get this done. So he did. His family went ahead of him and stayed back. While his wife and kids were traveling over the Atlantic Ocean, the boat they were in collided with another vessel, and there were 200 people perished in that shipwreck. But his wife survived. As soon as Horatio heard of this news, he jumped on the next boat. He went to meet with his wife over in Europe. But as Horatio was on his boat traveling towards Europe, around about the area where his children had died, their parents, he felt this wave of emotion come over him. And he returned to his cabin, he sat down with his book in his hand, and he wrote these words.
Thank you.